So what we're going to do today is talk about attraction customers. But since we don't really know who the customers are yet, I'm going to invite you to take this to be more general in nature. How to we're going to talk about just attraction. Because I think if you understood or looked at attraction in different ways, right? We're going to share ideas. But I think if you looked at attraction in different ways, you might find your own unique way to apply it. To not just have it be something you talk about, to not have it be just some nebulous concept, to actually have it be a tool that you can use. So that's how we're going to try to approach it. So before we get into attraction, let's talk about the magic behind the curtain that makes it possible, right? And by magic, I just mean math. And what I mean by that is, like, if you drop an apple, it falls to the ground magically, right? But we know that that's gravity. But we all know that that's also math, right? That something's going to fall at 9.8 meters per second squared. It's math that explains that and helps understand what happens when things happen. So how many people have heard of the concept of the 6 degrees of separation? Everybody, right? Everybody knows what that means? What that actually means is that the difference between you and every other human being on this planet, not the country, not the town, there's only less than 6 people that connect you and every other human being on this planet. So I want you to think about that for a bit. That means that everybody, anybody, people in China, people in Cambodia, right? Every living person is only 6 people, less than 6 people away from you. You just don't know who they are. For example, everybody met the Bilal. If you haven't met Bilal yesterday, you will meet him. He's a phenomenal person, tremendous human being, great mission that he's incorporated us in his vision. And for those of you that just, how many people just met Bilal in the last day? Okay. So you just met Bilal in the last day. But literally, really, you were connected to him over 3 years ago. I met him about 3 years ago. And either you know me, or you know somebody that knows me, or you know somebody that knows somebody that knows me. And the reason why I know that is because you're sitting here. So 3 years ago, you were already connected to this vision coming together, this whole thing starting to happen. You just didn't see the connections. You just can't see the connections. Everyone in this room is connected to both presidential candidates by less than 6 people. You know me. My brother worked for a senator. The senator knows them both, right? So you just don't know. So the reason why I like to start here is because just the energy's already changed in the room. Everybody's now lighting up a little bit, because in the back of your mind, there's probably a voice, I'm going to try to encourage a voice to remind you that there are going to be some people that, okay, let's put some math to it. There are hundreds of thousands of people right now, already today, at this moment, that has already made the decision to change their life, to eat better, to do the right thing, and they're already educated on the difference between synthetic vitamins versus whole food. They already know what you know, or more than you know. Hundreds of thousands of people already. You're connected to them by less than 6 people. There are people that are right now saying, you know what? I have to do something different. I need to start a home business. I need to do something different. I need to get out of this box. This is not who I'm meant to be. I'm meant to be greater than this. I know I'm more than this. You're connected to those people by less than 6 people. There will be people that get introduced to this company and change this company. Individual people will bring thousands or tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of customers and or representatives to this company that hasn't done it yet. You're connected to them by less than 6 people already. You woke up this morning already connected to them. So the reason why I like to start with that, and by the way, so I started reading about human networks and what we're talking about now, not social networks, just human networks. They've kind of become the same thing, but this was 14, Jasmine is 15, so this is 16 years ago, 17 years ago. There were already books out on human networks and the science of human networks. Here's another one exciting thing to throw into this bucket of ideas before we not even enter the presentation, but here's a good thing about starting with what I call the magic behind the curtain, just a paradigm that helps you understand your reality might be a little bit different. If you were to go out right now and take this idea of this dare, of this company, the products, anything that excites you about this company, but every day first start thinking about less than 6 people in this whole world, I'm connected to everybody by less than 6 people, your business is already different. If you truly adopt that and you truly are driven by that belief, your ability to talk about it goes up. Your willingness to get uncomfortable goes up. Why? Because this could be one of those less than six people that can change everything. Just that little understanding can change who you are right now. Or I could stop right now, and if you went and applied just that idea, which isn't mine, it's science, but if you went and applied that one idea every day for the next year, is there anybody that thinks you would not be in a different place by the 365 days from now? Don't just view it as the business, view it in the person you need to do to advance your career, the person you need to do to work something, the whatever you need, the person you need to help with some challenge you're in. Less than six people, less than six people, less than six people. That's all it is. Here's the other thing about the math behind that. The more people you put into the bucket, the less degrees of separation there actually are. So as the population grows, it'll go from 6 degrees to 5 degrees to 4 degrees to 3 degrees. Here's the really exciting thing, and then we'll start the presentation. Right? Some of you are already lit up, I can tell, and I appreciate that because it wakes me up. Somewhere during this presentation, I might wake up, so hold on. Warning in advance. So the more people you put in, the less connections there are. The more people you put in the bucket, the less connections there are between you and any other person on the planet. That should drive and inspire you by itself. By itself, that should just drive and inspire you. So now, that's the background idea I want you to constantly think about as we go through ideas on how to increase, how to affect this idea of attraction. So when we think of attraction, generally we think about it in three broad categories. And we're going to stick to that. My whole intention today is not to give you some magic bullet. It's not to give you some you know, clever words. It's just to help you with perspective. It's to help you formulate ideas around how things are could possibly work and how you might be able to apply those things in your interests. That makes sense? Just like that's why I started off with the 6 degrees of separation. Because that perspective alone completely changed how I did everything. And this was 14, 15 years ago. But you know, just being driven by that knowledge that I don't know who you are. I don't know, are you the one connection, the two connection, the three connection, the four connection, the five connection, to this thing I really, really, really want, really, really, really bad. So let me take some time, conversate, explore, and look and see. And it keeps you open-minded, it keeps you optimistic, keeps you leaning forward, which is not normal. So when people think about attraction in three major ways, gravity, right? Gravity, I already used the example today. You drop an apple, it hits the ground. You step off the stage, I'm gonna touch the ground. That's how I use my levitation skills, right? So that's what gravity is. But one thing we know about gravity, we may not know all the science about gravity, but some of the big ideas about gravity is, you know, gravity keeps the planets in orbit, right? Gravity is what keeps the planets, you know, the moon revolving around the Earth, but gravity is also keep the Earth revolving around the sun. Gravity also keeps the whole galaxy revolving, you know, everything is held together by this thing called gravity. But one thing that we all know affects it is the size of objects, right? Jupiter, biggest planet in our solar system, has way more gravity than Earth. Why? Because Jupiter is way bigger. So the concept we want to carry forth from the gravity school of thinking is size matters. Space matters, size. And if you go to science class or physics class, there's going to be a lot of discussion around matter and mass, right? Here's the thing, we're going to play with some words to help it make it practical to you. Okay, so when you think about gravity, once you think about this invisible force that's just the technical explanation is the gravity is attraction between objects. Okay, size matters. But I also want you to just focus on the word, if you're writing notes, just underline the word matter. And I want you to think about it in two ways. Matter in terms of how much physical space it takes up, but I want you to also think of it in terms of what matters to you. Okay, it's gonna be very helpful. What matters to you. Same word. So I'm trying to give you these little cheat things I do to connect concepts together to make them useful and put them in a way that you can apply it. The next form of attraction that's very common, you know, even children understand this conceptually, is magnets, right? Magnetism, right? Put two magnets together, bam, they suck together, right? You take a magnet and you put it next to something metal, bam, it sticks to the refrigerator, right? We don't really know how. You know, scientists can explain a good chunk of it. But one thing we do know that's a component of magnetism, especially if you ever did the experiment where you make a magnet as a kid with wires and a battery and a nail, is energy. The movement of electrons is something that has to do with creating magnetism. Energy. So the operative word here we're going to think about is energy. Think about energy as movement. Energy and movement. Energy and movement. We're going to combine some of these terms to make them so you can create some pictures in your head that make sense to you. Energy and movement. Energy. The final, when you think about attraction, is kind of in the human sense. Attractive woman, attractive person, attractive human being. I'm attracted to that person or that idea. Here's the idea I want you to think about human attraction. It's not arbitrary. It's not random, right? When you think about it, I want you to consider this. Remember, these are just ideas for consideration, right? But a large part of human attraction has to do with programming. By programming means that it's stuff that's already in place inside of you. So for example, biology. There's a lot of biological programming that makes you like other people on the planet, right? That makes you like this type of person more than this type of person. A lot of it's biological, but it's programmed. You didn't invent it. You didn't sit down and say, okay, I like women. I like brown eyes, whatever it is. A lot of that is just there. It's pre-programmed. When you took that first air breath and started to cry for the very first time, you already had some wiring in there that's going to make you, you're going to translate that into some type of attraction. The other part, though, is actually taught. It's cultural. This is the type of people we think to be beautiful. Standards of beauty, everybody know that standards of beauty are not universal, right? That everybody know that what we in America think as being the beautiful standard of beauty, like if we describe it or pick a picture out and you go to all the different countries in the world, it's going to be different in all the different countries in the world. Everybody realize that? Body type changes. All the features are different. You know, what we in some parts of the world agree to, wow, that's beautiful. In other parts of the world, they won't even see that person. They'll be looking at the person next to that person that we didn't look at, right? Because their cultural references, programming, is completely different. So the point I want you to carry away from here is that a large part of human attraction is based upon what is already programmed in that individual human, okay? So we got gravity, mass, size, matter, things that matter. We have magnets, right? It's somehow driven by movement, energy, combining those two terms, and people, pre-programmed. So let's break them down and see how we can make this a tool somehow. We're going to do it section by section. Gravity, mass, matter. This is why I wanted you to underline the word matter. So since we know that Jupiter has more gravity than Earth, because Jupiter is bigger than the Earth, so in your world, now we're going to finally define this down to the business, right? Your world of the business, your world of who you are, your world of the business, we want to ask yourself, how can you create more mass, more space, more stuff? How can you create more stuff? And what I want to encourage you, the easiest way to do it from the perspective of this business is just to focus on being a product of the product. If you can focus on being a product of the product, you're at least starting from a place that you want to attract people to come to, right? Being a product of the product. Now, I want you to look at the product as a couple of different things. At least four things. I want you to look at the product of who we are. Who we are as evangelists, as representatives, as fans of New Earth. Who are we? And we're just going to focus on four areas. But I want you to view these as products, as separate products we can focus on. One is obviously the food. We know it's raw, we know it's raw, we know it's raw, wild, raw, and powerful. We know that. That's one product. But another product, another part of who we are, is this idea of this no-nonsense, real, non-fake lifestyle. This lifestyle built around our natural and nature and, you know, positiveness. That's a part of our product. That's a product. That's something we are and something we deliver. That's a product. The other is your lifestyle. Your lifestyle. We have free enterprise and self-reliance, right? So one way to look at the business is just like, oh, it's a business. It's a way you can make some money. It's a way you can make some money on the lifestyle. You can get these different things. You can get rich if you want. You can do these different things. Another way to look at that that's a little bit more inclusive is we represent free enterprise. We represent free enterprise and self-reliance. Free enterprise means you're not restricted to how you create your economics. You're not dictated to how you create the limits of your own economics. If you want the limits of your own economics to be X, you can. If you want it to be triple X, you can. If you want it to be 3,000X, you can. It's up to you. Same with self-reliance. That means that we represent a model or an idea that says you determine, if you dare, you determine who you are and the limits to what limits you will accept. You determine that. You determine what game you play. You determine when the game is over, or is this just a setback? Is this the end of the game, or is this just a setback, or this is just a reset, or is this a pause? You determine that. You determine how you feel about what's happening around you. You determine that. You determine if what just happened made you angry, sad, mad, glad, motivated, whatever. Self-reliance. You are the source of that power. We represent that. That's product. Of all the products we have listed up there, the one that might be most needed in 2016 is that. Right now, most people are the opposite of that. I am powerless. There's nothing I can do. It's hard for me to even think of examples because I force myself not to think this way constantly. But this is a very common way of thinking. Why vote? Doesn't matter. I can't get out of this. I can't win. I can't do this. That's not for me. That's somebody else deciding. That's them saying, I live in a world where I believe that somebody else decides what my limits are. I live in a world where I believe that somebody else decides who and what I can do. That's not what we say. We sell a different product. And this is the one product I'm going to encourage you to sell. Sell this one. Sell it. Sell it hard. Because they are dying. Of all the products we sell, this is the one that people are most desperately trying to find. This is the one that they're most desperately wanting to buy. And if they can truly understand that this is what you're selling, the cost of this doesn't matter. They really don't care. I saw on the news right before I came down today that we're going to spend $380 million in the next couple of weeks on pet costumes for Halloween. I didn't make that up. That's a true number. We're going to spend $380 million in the next 2 weeks on pets, on costumes for pets for Halloween. All right, $380 million is nothing to sneeze at, right? And that's for one day for their pet. So you go sell this self-reliant, self-determination idea, I think it's going to have a value way more than $300 million. Only point I'm trying to make. The last product we sell, we started with this. It was the magic behind the curtain, the math behind the curtain. We live in a network-centric time. What we sell is that we are aware that we live in this time. We understand that we live in this network, this time of networks, and we're a part of networks. And the whole thing is we started off with. And because we understand the massive potential in that, we do everything we do from a human-centric point of view, a human network-centric point of view. We think about it. It doesn't just happen to us. Everybody else is a part of networks. We apply it, we think about it. We get up in the morning and we think, wow, I'm a part of this massive network. Less than six people, anything I want, everybody I know, anything I need. So how can I live a life in a way to take advantage of this human, and the way we do that is by living a human network-centric approach. Magnetism, that was gravity. Now we're gonna talk about magnetism. What's the operative word in magnetism? What makes magnet works? What are we gonna focus on? Energy, right. What's another word we've connected to mean the same thing as energy, conceptually? Movement, yeah, see how these things? That's why we use these terms and these phrases that are simple, because we can recall them. And if we can recall them, we don't need paper around us. We don't need a book with us. We don't need a reference when we walk out into this world. We can think, okay, I'm gonna be a magnet today. What makes a magnet work? Energy, okay. How do we pull this energy thing into our little world to make it useful? Okay, let's talk about one way is to look at it as creating it, right? Where does energy come from? The most common reference to energy is people describing a situation where it's not there. The most common reference to energy is by people not having it. That is by far the most common reference to energy there is. Except for in one scenario where it's the complete opposite. When we talk about kids, especially under three, then it's the opposite. They have so much energy, they're running around all the time, they blah, 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 they just boom, 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 right? So we know that energy, based on that little example, we know that energy is not a function of size and matter and food and things, because if you look at, I'm 206 pounds, right? And I eat a lot of food, I eat way more food than somebody, a child that's three or two. I eat way more food than them, and I have more of everything biologically. But guess who's gonna burn the most energy off? Guess who's gonna run around like energy, like they have a main pipeline in energy? The kid, right? So it obviously has to do something other than that. Another quick example is, you wake up in the morning, you realize you're late. Well, normally you wake up in the morning, takes you forever to get out of bed, but the time between you and getting dressed is like a whole hour of conversations and dragging and da, 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 that whole thing going on, and you're making it through the way, trying to get going. But on one day you wake up and you realize you forgot to set the alarm clock, you look at the alarm clock, you're late, and that morning is different. Boom, you're out of bed, you're jumping, you're thinking about multiple same things at the same time, like, how can I get dressed real fast? What's the shortest way I can get to work? What excuse am I gonna say to the boss when I get there? You got all these things going through your mind, and you move in at like warp speed until you realize it's Saturday. So here's my question. Where'd the energy come from? You didn't eat anything different the day before. You didn't take any super drug. You didn't plug yourself into the wall. You just thought different things. You created the energy on the spot. Now, it was out of fear, but you created the energy, a surplus of energy, on the spot, out of nowhere, instantly, just like that. So, okay, so since we all know that that's possible, what can we do to create energy? What about this business create energy in you? These are questions not for you to answer for yourself. What about the ideas of what we're doing? What about the possibility of where we are? What about the possibility of who you are, right, given the products we represent? What about that gives you energy? When you can identify these things, guess what you want to do about that? Do it all the time. Do it on a regular basis. If thinking about, man, if I could just talk to 10 people, one of those 10 might have a chronic illness that I actually may be able to change their entire life. If that motivates you, then at least once a day, think about that. Let that energy do what it does and create it, right? Because the energy is going to make you that magnet. It's gonna attract some things that you need to happen. The next is, what can you focus that energy on? Okay, now that I thought up and I thought of, wow, I thought the thoughts I think to make me feel the way I wanna feel. So now I'm, boom, I created that instant energy. So now what do I do with it? I don't wanna just waste it. I don't wanna just sit here and vibrate, right? I wanna do something with that energy. So you need to think of, okay, how can I focus this energy? And it doesn't have to be an all-day focus. I know you have a life and stuff going on. Here's the thing, if you take an intense amount of energy and you focus it for 20 minutes, you'll be surprised at what happens if you did that for 365 days. If you look at the end of the year and see what changed in my life by focusing a massive amount of my created energy for 20 minutes a day. If you do it in fitness, your body will look different. If you do it in your knowledge base, your skill set will be different. If you do it in trying to find the right people in this network we're a part of, by the end of the year, your human network will be different. Guaranteed, has nothing to do with luck. It has everything to do with the magic behind the curtain, which is math. It's there. 20 minutes a day, highly focused energy, right? The next thing is, okay, wow. I so believe in what I am. I so believe in what I'm doing. I so believe in this mission. This energy feels so great. The next thing we should want to do, because we live in a human-centric point of view, is share it, right? Who can I share this with? Who can I share? Just that a question right there is a question that many of you has never asked. You've never gotten into a place of highly energy. You created a bunch of energy, feel really good, focuses on something that makes you feel great, and then said, okay, wow, who else can I help feel just like this? Because that would be a contribution to them, right? Whether it be a friend, whether it be a new acquaintance, whether it be a foe. You treat a field foe like this, guess what you will be over time? Friends. You can't add value to people's life and not have them be friends. You don't have to agree with everything they do. They don't have to agree with everything they do. But at the end of the day, this is what's going to connect you. And this is going to mean more than anything else. This is going to be more than the fact that you like the same TV shows. This is powerful stuff, and you can't undeny it. The last part of attraction is human, right? And we already said that most of human attraction is built on pre-programming. The good news is, well, great. That means we have nothing to do with it. They're already pre-programmed. They're already there. They already are who you need them to be. And I mean that in a totality. I mean, they already are. If you're looking for customers, they already are. They have already decided, I am going to change my diet, I'm going to enhance my life, I'm going to do these different things. They've already know the things you know are more. They just need to see you. They just need to see you. You don't have to sell them. You don't have to sell them a thing. You just have to be known. They just have to see you. They just have to understand, hey, this is what I'm about. Oh, really? It just so happens that I'm trying to find a new fill in the blanks. Oh, really? I just read this article last week where algae is blah, blah, blah. Oh, really? What are the odds of this? What are the odds that I would sit next to you at a bus station and you happen to be my parents, blah, 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 blah? You know what happens when you start to do some of the things I'm talking about? If you really apply them, that little scenario I talked about where what are the odds of this? They will happen all the time. All the time. Don't you know people in your life that you wonder, that they say, man, you know, it's so amazing. I decided I wanted to be a movie star, and I went to this cocktail party, and a movie producer just happened to be there. You know people like that. Water's just falling all over the place. The energy, gravity, happening right before our eyes. Right? You know people like that. They call them lucky, charmed. Things always go their way. They're just different. No. The thing is, there's nothing different in the reality of their life than it is in your life. The same people you need to meet, you sat next to at the bus station, in the restaurant, too. You just weren't lit up. They couldn't see who you were. They didn't know that you were who they were looking for. You don't walk around with a sign on your head. But I guarantee you, you've met the person you most need to meet 5, 6, 7, 8 times last month. And what I mean, I don't mean rationally walk by. I mean probably talk to. The reason why, because all the stuff we're talking about is happening in the background anyway. The people you need to meet, you're being forced into their environment anyway. You're not bumping into these people because you just randomly bump into people. You drew them there anyway. Because even though you don't want to admit it, even though you might not be brave enough to say, I am self-reliant and these are the things I believe in. Thank you for reminding me about this gravity thing. And then, you know, even though you may not be brave enough to say it, it is who you are. If it is who you are, the math is happening anyway. 1 + 1 = 2, whether you say it's 3 or 4 or not. The math is at work happening anyway. So if you do believe in these things, just subtly, that's a lot. Why now? The reason why it's a lot, because we now know, well, we only connected, it's less than six people there anyway. And the math isn't that really that big. It's not like I'm trying to run into a sea of 6 billion people and trying to find who are the people I need to meet. No, I'm trying to work within a group of six that I'm already connected to. That's why it works so fast and so well. And the people that get better at this, they do it better at this because what they do is they take the number from 6 to 5 to 4 to 3 to 2. And the thing that's really interesting is that when we really apply this, then it doesn't matter who you meet because your energy will be so good and so resonant and your ability and willingness and intention to share will be so focused that when you sit next, get next in the proximity of these people, they know who you are, they light up as who you are, then people in their network can see them. Did everybody follow that? This should inspire you. It inspires me. People always ask me, why am I so optimistic? Why am I so happy? Are you like Pollyanna? Does thing ever go wrong? Yeah, crap goes wrong all the freaking time. But I choose what I focus on. I can slow down and focus on that 8 bad things I see in this 8 minutes, or I can focus on, I can see the 8 bad things, acknowledge that the 8 bad things are bad, but I can focus on these 3 good things for the 8 minutes. That's a choice. And why do I choose to do that? I choose to do that because of all this stuff. If I'm gonna play the odds, if I'm gonna roll the dice, I'm not gonna try to beat the house. I'm not gonna try to break the math. The worst thing I wanna try to do is become the wrong house. And what I mean by that is, all of this stuff works. Now that this is just my idea. It's gonna happen, it's happening behind the scenes anyway. Who you are, right? Who you are. That's why we focus on do things to increase your size, your mass, right? And what do we use? What do we substitute for the matter means space, right? How much space does this take up? There's amount of matter in this that has something to do with the amount of gravity it generates. But what word are we going to, what substitute meaning are we going to use for the word matter in terms of taking up space? What matters to you? What matters to you? Einstein pointed out mathematically that there's a relationship between matter and energy, right? The whole EMC squared thing. In fact, he basically says they're the same thing. That's pretty much true today. Modern physics say there's no separation between matter and energy. They're the same thing. So I'm going to propose to you that what matters to you gives you energy. Think about it. What matters to you gives you energy. That's why it's so critical that we focus on who we are. That whole thing about filling up your space. All I'm trying to do is help you get down the road of what being clear on what matters to you as related to this business. The more you won't do, people are too busy or too lazy to do anything for nothing. That's all of us. But none of us are too busy or too lazy to do things that matter to us. So the minute we make something matter enough, we will create enough stuff in our world. By stuff, I mean both action and physical things, to create enough gravity, right, to change what we perceive to be being attracted into our world. The good news is already there, looking for you, desperately looking for you in some cases, praying for it, talking about it all the time. If I could just meet this, if I could just find this person, if I could just, if, and here you walk in. And when you walk in, either you're gonna walk in and be a stranger and you're gonna be so caught up in the 8 bad things that's in your awareness that you're gonna walk into the room, you're gonna answer that person's prayer or your own, and you're gonna be so caught up in your 8 bad things that you focused on, you're gonna walk by and you're gonna say the complimentary, hey, how you doing? Nice to meet you, have a nice day. Oh, nice. And you're gonna miss it. Or you're gonna walk into that room and you've been focused on those 3 things and you're so fired up, you know it's less than 6 people, you're looking for that person. You walk into that room saying, where is that person? Oh, bam, you walk up, you meet somebody, hey, you need to meet this person. Oh, really? I can't wait to meet this person. Why? Because it might be that person I need to meet anyway. And when you meet that person, they're gonna see it. They're gonna say, wow, you don't have to say it. They're gonna feel it. Wow, that person seems like they wanted to meet me. And the truth is, yes. And now all of a sudden, they see you for who you are, and the conversation is completely different. And now you see them for who they are. And then all of a sudden, it becomes one of those, what are the odds of this? How did this just happen? How did, what? I came on a random meeting and sit in the lobby, And I've been waiting to, those are the conversations that happen, So we're gonna wrap this up really quickly. You know, if I didn't, if we didn't make this practical, then this was just a conversation. That's all it was. Good ideas, ooh, gravity, wow. Hey, water bottles even fell, that was kind of cool. But if you're not gonna walk out of that door and change your gravity, change your magnetism, change the probability of human attraction working in your behavior, then we just had a 35-minute conversation that was interesting. And that might be cool, but what the heck, right? That's not why we're here. So here's what we're gonna do, really fast. Everybody's gonna think of one thing about, let's just call it the New Earth experience. That can be anything. That can be the products, the company, the people, the events, the team, an individual product, the comp plan. I don't care what it is. Something in the New Earth experience that excites you. And we know now, we know why that's so important. Think about it for, you're only gonna have like 20 seconds to think about it. Here's my rule before we play this game, because we're gonna play this game, so get ready. Here's the rule to play in my games. If you don't know what to say, make it up. But there's a rule to making it up. If you make it up, and I encourage you to do that because you know more than you think you know, you're just not accustomed to saying what you think. So if you don't know what to say when we play this game and we say go, just start talking and make it up. I have one rule. It must be positive. You will make up a positive story. We're gonna make up a positive thing, right? So here's what we're gonna do really quickly. You're gonna either say or invent in this moment one thing that super excites you about the New Earth experience. And I'm gonna have you, and you're gonna share it with your neighbor, okay? Let's make it really fun and take all the pressure off. You will start off your story by saying, once upon a time. There's power in that, believe me. How old were you when you first heard that? What was your imagination like when you first heard that intro? What was possible in the world when you first heard that intro? Okay, there's power in that. So we're gonna start off this by saying, once upon a time. And it can either be now, it could be 5 weeks from now, it could be 5 years from now, but I want you to relate it to the New Earth experience. Let me give you an example. Now would be, oh man, I can't believe I found this company. I get it. I get that it's all about whole food. Whole food is like medicine to the body, and I found a company that is the best in the world at that. That's all it is about now. 5 years from now could be, man, I can't believe my organization is 50,000 people in 5 different countries. I can't believe that that is the reality I'm living. It's unbelievable, and I can't believe it started by this little company I found. Everybody see how it works? We're gonna start with once upon a time. Okay, everybody pick a partner really fast. Okay, who's next to you? Anybody left out? Okay, as you face me, as you're looking at me, the people on the right, the people on this side of the partnership, you're gonna go first. You're not gonna have long, you're only gonna have a minute. Everybody know the rules? Okay, if you don't have a, if anybody's left over, make a threesome. Okay, you ready? Hold on. Everybody remember the rules. Do participate. Don't ride this one out and not participate. You gotta buy. Make it up if you don't know what to say. The rule is it has to be what? Positive, okay. Right team, you ready? Go. All right. Pause. Left side, ready? Left side, ready? Go. Oh, you already did? Do it again. Here's the thing. Great job. Everybody give yourself a hand. Here's the thing. You know, I wish you could, the whole energy thing, it just can't be understated. I could literally, was there anybody during the last 2 minutes of that exercise that felt doubtful? That felt unempowered? That felt depressed? Did you think about the problems that you brought into your room with you today? That's the magic. That's the magic right there. The magic is in those little moments, you are literally being somebody else. You're still you, but you're being a better version of it. You're being a purposeful version of it, an energetic purpose of it. And that person, believe me, is magnetic. That person is highly magnetic. So I think I'm going to dare you. I'm going to dare you to want to be something enough and to want to be something enough, to want to do something enough, to want to affect something enough in your world to take this bigger dare on and use it as a way to prove yourself right or prove the math wrong. I want you to prove yourself right or prove the math behind the curtain wrong. Now, there's a lot of math behind the curtain. It's not about the math. It's about you wanting something bad enough to dare yourself to go do it. If you dare yourself to go do it deeply, the virtue of who you are will dare others around you to do the same thing. You don't even have to tell them to do the dare. You dare them by your presence. You dare them when you walk into the room. You dare them when they look into your eyes, because they're going to feel a difference between who you are in yourself and who they are in their own. And that's going to light the right people up. And they're going to love you for it, by the way. They're going to love you for that. So, I woke up. I did wake up, and thank you for that. I think my body's now on a combination of East Coast, West Coast time that's workable. Rockable. Thank you for your time and your attention. I appreciate it. Wild.